hometown. This is your hometown. This is your hometown. This is your hometown.
We have one of the most beautiful views we see on Idle Lake. We saw a landfill, but a much smaller landfill 35 years ago, and I understand it's going to get bigger. But now we see a water tower, and now from every, we have windows that look out towards the west. From every window in our house, we see these solar panels, and this huge, and I'm really worried about property values. I mean, we pay a lot of taxes. We worked very hard, we have a nice house, and I just don't think there needs to be anything more up on that hill. I mean, when we built our house, there was a farm there, and you looked out and you saw a farm, and you saw field work, and you saw, and it's really changed, and it's sad. It's very sad because we built our house and we've always lived there. We raised our kids there, and it's totally changed now. And I can't see it getting any worse. I mean, it upsets me. But we have to look at now, and I understand you don't live there and you don't look out and see it and you don't smell it occasionally, but we do. And you know, we've invested a lot in our property, and I hope you reconsider about approving this.
I came here a year ago specifically to get away from industry of any kind. Doesn't matter what it is. The minute it goes in, I'm out. There's no reason for me to stay anymore. I work in Syracuse. I moved 45 minutes away to get away from industry of any kind, of retail of any kind, of business of any kind. As a homeowner, I have a right to quiet, peaceful enjoyment. It's a right. You bring me in business, gone. No need for it anymore.
Trouble times will come to my hometown.
I'm sorry you made a bad decision to buy a house that was across from the landfill. That seems to be your own.
Wow.
You guys don't stand up for this community, shame on you guys, because a lot of you guys have been here a long time. You too, it's going to stink, it's terrible.
Why do we even consider compounding those issues? It seems like what we're doing is exacerbating what currently exists. We're making it worse. And unless there's some overwhelming, tremendous advantage to doing it, I think we should consider it.
We all invested our livelihood in our properties, and this isn't any different than hydrofracking. We know enough not to do this. We really do. If it's so great, I think the best place to put it is near the courthouse. That would be a good place to put it. This way here. That would be great, but I don't think they want it there either. I don't think anybody wants it, but. And you can say all you want, there are accidents in everything we do. And when an accident happens, all you're going to say is, we cleaned it up best we can. Next 80 years, won't be too bad. Your baby grows a third eye. The newspaper will probably highlight it and make some big money. But we don't need this, and we really seriously got to think about what we're doing here. This is ridiculous. We're not cave people. This is the town of Lincoln. My wife and I fool around. We call it Hootersville. When we come to vote, we say we got to climb the telephone pole. Today, I think we went down that road. It's got to go.
Thank you, Rick.
What's the matter? What's the problem?
You move next to the landfill and you're complaining about it.
To say that we chose this, no, we didn't. My children are the fifth generation to be born on that property. So when my parents bought the property, they signed a petition against the landfill, which went unheard and didn't matter. So I am just simply asking that you listen to us, please, and do the right thing.
My hometown. To my hometown. To your hometown. Said, son, take a good look around. This is your hometown.
But to have an industrial park here, that's a whole other ball of wax. And that's what I think that people are afraid of. And I am too. I don't want an industrial park here. I'm one of those people that came here because of the rural character.
I was explaining to my children what it was. And my daughter said to me, why would they choose lives over money? And I didn't have an answer for that. That's what I want you to take to all of them, is my daughter's face crying because she can't understand why they would choose money over her life. We would be looking at the plan from our property. And for it to not affect our property value is crazy. No one's gonna wanna live across from that. Right now we have a beautiful treescape. If I wanted to live in New York City, I would have moved to New York City. That's where my husband's from. I've been trying to tell him how great Madison County is, how wonderful it is, how our schools are wonderful, the community's wonderful. And every time something happens, he turns around and goes, really? Because we moved, we don't want to be here if things are going to happen like that. If we wanted industry across from our street, we would have moved to New York City. But something like this is not going to bring more people to this area. It's going to deter people. It will deter me. I will move. I don't want that near my house. I don't want my children growing up across from an industry. I will move.
Let's not turn this into that the coal jobs are coming back. Because that ain't happening. An industrial park in the town of Lincoln, frankly, in all likelihood, will not make a major difference unless it's in higher end STEM jobs. $12 an hour jobs in a fertilizer plant. It's not going to happen.
Another spot that's already so polluted from coal and gas and oil tankers. Why not put it someplace like that? I can't see damaging a spot that is still healthy and gorgeous, and it's not so badly tainted by city life, and that's what's going to happen over here.
We even purchased extra acreage just so we had that freshness, the woods. I worry about that. I have a 4.5-month-old baby, and I worry about that as well. I have a 3-year-old too, so you're going to be taking away our family. Because we're not going to stay here.
We're asked to come to a meeting. How many people are outside when we can't hear what's going on in here? And you can say, well, you'll get the minutes. You can read the minutes. It's not the same as hearing and being able to ask back what's in these minutes. So I would suggest any other meeting has to be in a building that we can all sit and talk in the same room.
I'm sorry you made a bad decision to buy a house that was across from the landfill. That seems to be your own.
Wow.
What's the matter? What's the problem? You move next to the landfill and you're complaining about it.
We all invested our livelihood in our properties. And this isn't any different than hydrofracking. We know enough not to do this.
Motion to open public hearing. It's 20 of 8.
Make a motion.
Second.
I'll start doing it.
Okay, is anybody here? Let's...
You are out of order. 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 You are out of order.
There are two really important things to remember about the First Amendment protection of free speech. The primary reason to have freedom of speech is to allow for public criticism of the stupid government. Stupid government. That's the sort of thing that can land you in jail in countries that don't have strong free speech protections.
Yes, sir. You have a question?
Вот вы говорите о полетах нашей авиации. В том числе о полетах стратегической авиации. Знаете ли вы, что Россия в начале 90-х годов полностью прекратила, как это делал Советский Союз, полеты нашей стратегической авиации в отдаленных районах патрулирования? Пару лет, тройку назад возобновили эти полеты. Так кто провоцирует? Мы, что ли? Значит, у нас две базы практически только за границей. И то на террористически опасных направлениях. В Киргизии, после того, как туда зашли боевики из Афганистана по просьбе киргизских властей, тогда Акаева президент.
Of Lincoln hereby enacts a one-year moratorium on fertilizer plants and